We are starting, so let's go ahead and go into that warm-up. And I got it right there on the screen for you. So 10 good mornings. Crank that music back up. There we go. Patty, I just got it up on the screen. I realized I actually forgot about that until just now. Let me get everybody muted. Hopefully y'all can, yeah, we got a good view with 12 people in here. Y'all can see everybody on that screen. For those rotations, you just rotate a little bit just like you would if you had a PVC pipe on your shoulders. That's it. That's it. When you get done with those rotations, you're going into those 10 lateral jump squats. So we're actually dropping down and touching the floor on that if you can in between your knees. So you got to get kind of deep just to loosen you up a little bit more. There you go. Get everybody full screen here so y'all get like you're here with us. Then you got those 10, so you can go 5 each side, just stepping those legs forward. Remember, you put that foot up wider than your hand. There you go. Then you're going to go into 10 skips each leg. Stephanie, do you remember Mary? Did you meet Mary? But she barely came. Her name is Mary Hunley. I mean, she barely came before we had to shut down. But she is a member. Get some air on those skips. Go 10 each leg. There you go, Patty Kane. You're good. Keep it up. Then you're right back into good mornings after those skips. That you can go hands right here. That's it. Bring those feet close together. You get a big hamstring stretch. Keep going, Rosemary. Keep going. You got that. Once y'all get done with those good mornings, remember you're back to just those rotations, just turning. 10 total. Let's go, Bob. I get them gold Metcons going. Got it, Patty. Yeah, after trunk rotations, you're back to those lateral squat jumps. Gonna heat you up a little bit. Oh, we got the My Zone screen behind me in the background. Y'all get to see if people get in the red or anything today. Got a lot of power work today, so that's gonna kind of dictate that. Got about a little bit less than 2 minutes left. I know y'all can't see the clock. We're working on that. We kind of got that over to the side right now. You got it. You got it. Keep rolling through. Is looking high energy today. Ryan, how's your back feeling, man? Got it? Okay. That'll do it. That and your knees and your hips. Oh, dude, that's a lot. They're nice though. They look good. Looking good, guys. Looking good. We got just about 30 seconds left in that warm up, and then we're going to move into our power work for today. Stephanie. Grab a kettlebell for those squat jumps and we can show it with a kettlebell and with a dumbbell. All right, take a break. Take a break, take a break. Should be good to go. So we'll switch that slide up. You just grab something light. All right, so we're going to go ahead. We got like four sections of this workout today, so we're going to blaze right there. I'm trying not to talk too much. So we're going to go into our power work to start today. So remember, when we do this power work, the goal is to move as explosively as possible. If we're doing that correctly, it's going to take a lot of energy from you, so it's going to make the rest of the workout a little bit tougher. That doesn't mean that you necessarily have to go heavy. You got to kind of feel that out. So on this first one, we got a weighted squat jump. You can do this with a dumbbell or a kettlebell. I like to do it with a kettlebell. I feel like it's a little easier to hold on to. So if you guys decide you want to go grab a kettlebell, you can. We've got a fair amount of those back over there. But we'll hold it right between the legs and then explode up. And you can actually, so you can go fast like Stephanie's going. Just make sure that you control that landing. Like, we're not trying to do like a bunny hop where you're super fast. It's more about getting as high as you can every rep and then controlling that landing. If the jumping and the impact bothers you at all, just come up out of that squat as fast as you can and then go back down, and you don't have to come up off the ground. So that's going to be 30 seconds. Then we got a 30-second break. Then we're going to go that chop and lift. So you got to keep a ton of tension through that torso and swing that kettlebell up and out to the side, or a dumbbell. You can hold the dumbbell horizontally. Arms are like slightly bent, but notice her feet are pivoting so that she's not twisting through her lower back. She can twist through her mid-back a little bit, but other than that, the feet are going just like it would if we threw a ball, swung a baseball bat, anything like that. So you should feel like you're going to have to grunt every time you move that dumbbell or you move that kettlebell on that movement, and we'll go 30 seconds straight on each side. Then we got – what we're going to do here is a broad jump and a back pedal just because of we're using these squares. So jump, big jump, and then back pedal back quick, and then explode on that jump. So your main focus there is actually like a max broad jump if you can. If the jumping bothers you, then we can do what we've got on the screen, which is just that short sprint and then back pedal back. That'll be a little bit more low impact. So if you got – anybody got any questions? If you want to grab a kettlebell, you can. I would say – like, you don't have to, I mean, like, guys, you don't need, like, definitely 53 would be, like, as heavy as you got to go. Like, you don't have to go real heavy on that. Just focus on getting off the ground fast. And we do have a bunch of those over there, too, depending on how you're feeling. I'd probably use, like, a 35. You guys got what you need at home? Got it. Another weight, ready to rock. This won't reach from right here. Come on. We gotta go MC Hammer. All right, we're going. If you're at home, we're gonna go here in about 5 seconds. You good, Bob?
Yeah.
All right, let's get it going. Go crank up some MC Hammer, get it going. All right, so y'all got it. Just bending those knees, try to keep that chest up. And remember, it's not about repping this out. You want good quality reps, so really try to explode up. There you go. Got it. Keep rocking, keep rocking. We got 1 second. All right, take a break. Go ahead and rest, Patty, rest. So we're going to be going to that chop and lift. So if you got a dumbbell, you can hold it. You can play around with this. I usually hold it by the ends of the dumbbell. Remember, you're going to come down to the hip, rotate up across the shoulder like you're throwing dirt with a shovel over your shoulder. We got about 8 seconds before we get started. Oh, thank you, Patty. Yes, I will get it on the screen. Oh, my gosh, I'm doing terrible. All right, let's get it going. Good work, folks. Remember, you're coming up on the toes. Hey, this is fast. Like, every time you're throwing that up over your shoulder, it should be a noticeable or like you're feeling yourself have to tighten up real quick, like you're about to get punched in the gut. I promise I'll remember to put that text on the screen. I keep forgetting to do that. You got so many things going on. All right, rest, rest. So we're going to get ready. We just got the other side coming up. Same movement, other side. Got about 13 seconds. You got plenty of time to rest. All right, let's get ready. 3, 2, 1, let's hit it. Let's hit it. There you go. As long as you bring those heels off the ground, you could turn your body a little bit with it, like even bring your eyes with that dumbbell or kettlebell. You gotta launch that thing. Launch it. Come on, we got it. 8 seconds left. 8 seconds left. Keep it up. All right, take a break. So we're getting ready for that. You guys can do a broad jump and back pedal or a sprint and back pedal. It's entirely up to you. But we got about 15 seconds before we get into it. So with this nice long rest period, you don't have any reason to hold back on this. You got about 8. Let's see. Here we go. Here we go. All right. 3, 2, 1. Let's hit it. Big jump, back pedal. Big jump, back pedal. Let's go. You got that. Yeah, keep rocking. Keep rocking. There you go, Patty. You got to jump past the cat, Patty. Almost there. Big jump, big jump. There we go. There we go. Let's go. Let's go. Yeah, buddy. All right, take a break. Take a break. All right, back to those weighted squat jumps. Remember, we are exploding on that. Uh-oh. What do we got? Let's see. So you got about 8 seconds. We're going to get to it. All right, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Here we go. Let's hit it. Love that hop, Dean. Love that hop, dude. That's good control. Got that, Rosemary. Keep it up. Rocking that old white kettlebell, the dirty kettlebell. 5 seconds left. Keep it up. All right, rest. Take a break. You ready, Patty Kane? Got a full, got a good 20 seconds before we go into that chopping lift. Got time. All right, let's see, what do we got? 8 seconds. Chop and lift, you pick whatever direction you want to go. We're going in 3, 2, 1, let's hit it. Remember, pivoting that foot, launch that thing over your shoulder. There you go, Dean, that's it. I see that pop every time you're turning. That's what we're going for right there. Keep pushing that pace. You got it. You got it. Come on. Come on. Come on. Keep going. Keep going. You're ready. You're ready. All right. Take a break. Take a break. Breathe. And we'll get to that other side here in about 20 seconds. Wait on this music to kick back in here. It got real quiet in here for a minute. Come on, sit. About to sing about mom's spaghetti. All right, 3, 2, hit it up. Do what? Let's go, let's go. There we go, there we go, there we go. Come on. Is this y'all's song, Diana? Yeah. Come on, we got it. We got 7 seconds. Let's go. Don't stop yet. Don't stop yet. All right, take a break. So remember, you got that option for a sprint and a back pedal, or you can broad jump and back pedal. Y'all missing it. Liam's dancing around the square. Oh, you might be able to see him over there.
Yeah, buddy.
All right, so we got about 5 seconds. Let's get ready, Patty. Here we go, Rosemary. 3, 2, 1. Game time. Game time. Let's go. Get low on that back pedal. Low on that back pedal. There you go. I'm gonna record that email. Not allowed to share it. Come on, big jumps, big jumps. Let's go. 10 seconds. Seconds. Keep it up. Keep it up. Let's go now. All right. Take a break. One more time through. Grab some water if you need it real quick. And we're going right back into those weighted squat jumps. All right, here we go. Get ready. 5 seconds and we're rolling. Weighted squat jumps. 3, 2, 1. Let's get it. Let's get it. You're ready. Go, go, go. Go time. That's it. We got good models. We got Brian and Diana. We got the husband and wife demonstrating today on camera. Come on, let's go. You got it. You got it. Yeah. That's it. That's it. Last set. Last set on these. Couple seconds left. Get one more. One more. All right, rest. Good job. So we're getting ready for that chop and lift. Chop and lift. Oh, I didn't set that enough. Yeah. All right, we're going here. What do I do? All right, go, go, go. Hit it. I'm going to move that clock today. I'm going to go right there. That's what I was thinking. No. You can see it, look, like, right? Keep going, guys. Keep going, guys. Come on. All right. Take a break. Get ready for that other side. Get ready for that other side. You got time. About 15 seconds. 15 seconds. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Get it going. Chop and lift. Chop and lift. Keep pushing. Keep pushing. You got this. Last set on this. Don't forget to turn those feet. There you go, Patty Kane. I see you launching that thing up. Just don't let it go. Yeah, about 3 seconds left, 3 seconds. All right, take a break, take a break. All right, so last one on those broad jumps. Don't hold anything back, broad jumps or the sprint, broad jumps or the sprint. All right, you got about 5 seconds. We're going to dig in. Dig in. Big jumps. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Yeah. There you go. Don't trip over that. You see that ledge, right, on this mat? I ate it. I rolled my ankle on that one day. It was terrible. Come on. Come on. Let's go. 10 seconds. Big jumps. Big jumps. Five left, five left. Big jump, big jump. Come on. That's it. Rest. All right, grab some water. If you need some water, we're going to get ready for this next part. I'm going to make sure I get my text on the screen here. That works. There it is, right there. So you're going to need a single dumbbell for this as well. Good work. All right, so for this next part, you will need something that you can press overhead. And then we're also going to squat it, whatever. It depends on what weights you got, but ideally you'll be limited by what you can press overhead. So we're going to start out today. We've got – get out there. Get out of the way, Diana. They're married. They don't have to distance, right? All right, first movement, we got that Renegade Row. You can just use one dumbbell, and we're going to alternate sides with that. So she'll pull and just leave it in the middle, in between your hands. Remember, we don't want to twist or rotate those hips side to side, so we're going to be alternating there. 40 seconds worth. With some of this stuff today with our strength work, remember we were doing sets of 30 seconds, and then we were taking a break at like 20 or 30-second break, and then we progressed into 40 seconds. Now we're doing an extra round, whereas we were doing three rounds. Now we got four rounds, so we're increasing or progressing you that way this week. Then we'll bring that weight up. You can hold it down low, or you can hold it up in the goblet position, and we're going to go into lateral squats. So this is where we keep the feet wide, and we want those toes pointed straight forward so we use the hips correctly, and sit way back and get deep on this. Use that weight to help you balance as you drop down into that. Then we're going to go to our half-kneeling shoulder press. So if your left leg is forward, you're going to press with the right. If your right leg is forward, we're going to press with the left. So you'll start out in that rack position, then press up arm by the ear. And every rep, we got 40 full seconds. So we're going to spend about 3 seconds coming down as you go through that. So press back up, full 3 seconds coming down on that. So that's our strength set. Renegade rows, lateral squats, and then half kneeling press. Each side, we're going to go 40 on, 20 off. So y'all get your weights ready. We're going to get the clock ready. If you need any modifications, let me know in the comments. Stephanie's got y'all out here. 40 seconds. All right, I got my clock ready. Y'all ready? We'll get going. We're going to have about 6 seconds once I hit this button. Nuh-uh. All right, so five. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Renegade Row, let's hit it. So we're alternating arms. So you just want to put that dumbbell down in between your hands. Oh, Dean, you're good to go with that too, buddy. You got two dumbbells. Rock out. Ooh, 20 seconds left. Keep going. Keep going. Got about five. We ain't done yet. Hey, yeah, so you should be aiming for at least 8 each side on this stuff with 40 seconds. And then if you have a weight that allows you to keep going, then we want to keep pushing. If we got something heavier, then you're welcome to go grab something heavier. Does that make sense? So the goal is to get you to really struggle around 8 repetitions each side. But if – all right, let's go. Next move, we're going lateral squat. But if your weight is lighter, definitely try to push some more. We got to get that stimulus where it's challenging enough to cause your body to have to react. Yeah, dude, we just keep it out. It's way better. Remember, you want to be awkwardly wide on this movement. Big, wide stance. Got about 8 seconds left. Let's keep it up. Keep pushing. Keep rocking. All right. Take a break. We got a 20-second break, and we're going into that half-kneeling press with the right arm. So if you're pressing with the right arm, that means our left leg is going to be forward. You got it, Patty. You're ready. 5 seconds. So we got a good 3 second drop on this as y'all go through this too. All right, let's go. Press up and then 3, 2, 1, all the way down. So we are going to pace you on this a little bit. There you go. Remember that active toe, try to curl those toes underneath in the back so that you can create some tension through those glutes. So you should be kind of squeezing your butt a little bit. That's halfway. That's it, buddy. 5 seconds, 5 seconds, let's go. All right, rest, good job. So we'll get ready for the other side, but we got a full 20 seconds. All right, 3, 2, 1, let's go, other side. Keep rocking, guys. Keep rocking. You got it. So you got about 15 seconds, just over halfway. Then we're trying to get that arm by the ear at the top. Locking out. Don't let it lean you over. Don't let that midsection move. You got to keep fighting.
5 seconds. Get one more.
Come on. You got one more. All right. Rest. Good job. Back in those Renegade Rows. So we're alternating. Remember just putting that dumbbell down right in between your hands. All right, let's hit it. Let's hit it. We got 40 seconds. Halfway, guys, halfway. Keep rocking. Remember, we're fighting that rotation, so your feet can be a little bit wider than your hips. Three, two, one. All right, good to go. Take a break. So we're getting ready for those lateral squats. Big, wide stance. We want those feet straight forward. All right, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Try to sit back deep on these. Here we go, Dean. Remember that trailing leg is going to stay straight. That's it, folks. Keep it up. We got about 15 seconds left on that. Come on, we got it. Come on, keep it up. Get one or two more each side. All right, take a break. Getting ready for that half kneeling press. So remember to curl those, get that active toe, curl those toes underneath in the back. Engage those glutes. All right, let's hit it. Go. 3 seconds down. Good, Patty Kane. I like that pace going down. Got it, Rosemary. Yeah, Dean. Got it, dude. Almost there. A couple seconds left. One more. Let's go. Rest. ready. You got about 8 seconds. You got time. Three, two, one. Let's go. Maybe you can play around with that position. Whether you keep it in tight or you go out wide, find where it's a little more comfortable on your shoulder. That's it. 15 seconds left. We got plenty of time. Plenty of time. Almost there. All right, take a break. Hey, we're gonna mix it up this time. So every time you row, 2 second pause. Place it back down, pull it up, 2 second pause. Get it going. Three, two, go. So 2 second pause every time you pull that dumbbell up. That gives the dog time to lick your face. Pause a full 2 seconds every time you pull. Got it. Let's go. Got 3 seconds. Keep rolling. All right. Take a break. Good job. So we're gonna add that 2 second pause here. Hey, same thing. 2 second pause on the down part. Every time you squat, hold 2 seconds, come back up. Let's get it. So same thing, drop down, hold 2 seconds, come back up. We got it. 2 second hold at the bottom. Come on, hold for me, hold. Get over there, hold right there, Dean, hold there. 2 seconds and then come back up. Think of it as a pause squat, just on one side. Got it. Ooh, there it is. Yeah. All right, rest. Good job. Let's get ready for that half kneeling press. Remember, we still got 3 seconds down. So we'll just keep this that 3 second drop the whole time, just like we've been doing. And go. That's it. Stephanie, on the last round of shoulder press, next time, we'll do like 20 seconds, as many as they can, and then we'll do a 20-second hold at the top. I'm excited. I don't know. I did okay last night. Come on now. 5 seconds, guys. Keep it up. All right. Take a break. My bad if I had coffee breath right then. Just got going. All right, other side, let's get it. We got it. Come on, halfway. Almost there. 13 seconds left. We're going to keep grinding. I know it's getting tough. It's our third round. We got one more after this. All right. Take a break. We'll keep all the rest of the stuff the same. No, just the press. Yeah, we'll say like max reps, 20 seconds, and then hold. Back to the top. Last time through. Let's get it. Come on, we got this. We got 40 seconds worth. Last time through on this, folks. Keep pushing. Actually, keep pulling. If every time you go to switch arms and you don't feel a lot of weight on that arm holding you up, you're probably shifting your weight back a little bit too far. We want to make sure we don't let that butt get up in the air. 5 seconds. Don't stop. Don't stop. It's your last set of these. Last set. Come on. Keep going. And break. Rest. Good job. Let's get up. Shake it out. Get ready for those lateral squats. Tank is so camouflaged on there, Rosemary. It's funny. You can barely see him. All right, let's go. Got those lateral squats. We keep the feet wide. There it is. Sink back into that. Sink into it. Remember, feet are straight on that. Killing it, folks. Killing it. You got it. You got it. Come on. Come on. Keep it up. Keep it up. Five left. You got time to get another one on that other side. All right. Rest. All right. Last set of shoulder press. We're going to go as many as you can for that first 20 and then hold for the last 20 seconds. So crank them out. It's going to be good with a heavy weight. Depends on your pace. You got it. You got it. Let's go. All right, go. So crank them out. Max reps for 20 seconds. And then we're going to give a 20-second hold. This is that last set. You got it. Keep cranking on them. Keep cranking on them. Come on. The best you can on this last set. Best you can. We're getting ready to have that hold. And hold. Hold. See if you can maintain that. Woo! Let's go. Let's go. Lock it out. Lock it out. 10 seconds. 10 seconds left. Almost there. That's it. Good job. Good job. And bring it down. Bring it down. Rest. All right. So last set. Same thing on the other side. All right. So let's get ready. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go, let's go, let's go. As many as you can. So we are going fast on this. Well, we've been pacing ourselves on this, not pacing yourself, going fast. Just changing that stimulus up a little bit, but keeping that time the same. Keep it up, 5 seconds left on this, and then we're gonna hold. There you go, Rosemary, good job. All right, hold, high hold, up top, yeah, keep it locked out. Come on, keep holding, keep holding, keep holding. You got 5 seconds. Breathe, breathe, breathe. All right, get some water. Good job. Give it a little bit of time to take a break. What we got coming up next is all body weight. Unless you want to add a weight to it, you can, but it's just going to be some isometric holds. That pulled up on the screen. Remember that reverse plank, right? Like legs out straight. I think it's usually sideways. Yeah. All right, let's see. Last part of the workout today. Ideally, it was meant to be body weight, but we got some ISO holds. So each one of these is only going to last 20 seconds. But then we got a quick 10-second transition between. So first one is a split squat hold with the right leg forward, left leg behind. So she's going to drop down just like that with that knee about 1 to 2 inches off the ground. Good tall posture. If you want to hold a weight, you can, but you don't have to. We're going to hold that for 20 seconds. Then switch legs. Go to the other side. 20 seconds on that side. Then we're going to drop down to the floor. We're going to do a reverse plank. So remember, this is all about that backside. So she's going to engage her glutes, hamstrings, calves, and drive those hips up as high as possible. Play around with your hand position on that. You can turn usually sideways is probably the most comfortable, just like she had hers. So you're going to hold that 20 seconds. Then we're going to go right into a V-sit hold. So she's laying back. So you can go straight leg just like that. Or if you need to, you can bend your knees and hold right there as well. So those are our four movements. We're going to go through that three times, 20 seconds on and 10 seconds off. So I'm going to get this clock set, and we're going to be ready to go. We got 4 times 3. All right, so we're going to go here in 7 seconds. Remember, you can add a weight or you can go body weight. Split squat, hold. And ready, set, hold. Let that back heel come right up off the floor. Put most of that weight on the front leg. Hold tight. Keep that knee out. Don't let that knee go in. Keep that knee out. All right, rest. You got 10 seconds. And we're going to switch legs. All right, go. Go, go, go. It's a short rest, quick transition time. So it's really just enough time to switch sides. Rest. All right, so we got about 8 seconds, and we got that reverse plank. So remember on this, is straight legs, dig your heels in. Try to drive your hips up as high as you can. Go! Remember, we don't have much time on this. Get them hips up. Come on. You can bend your knees if you have to, but I want you to try that straight leg. Trying to create a tabletop. Tabletop, top of the body. You should feel those hamstrings firing up. Calves. Rest. All right, get ready for that V-sit hold. You're just going to lean back a little bit more. You can go arms out forward at your side. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. You got it. Keep rocking, keep rocking. 5 seconds. All right, rest. So we're going back to that split squat hold in 5 seconds. And go. Go, go, go. Drop down and hold. That's it, that's it. Keep it up. About 8 seconds left. All right, take a break, get ready. We're gonna switch sides, switch sides. All right, go. Got it, come on, try to keep that chest up. Drive that back knee towards the floor, but don't let it touch. All right, rest. Let's get ready for that reverse plank. And we're going. Reverse plank, hips high, dig your heels in. Hips up high, hips high, hips high. Come on, keep it up. There you go. 5 seconds. All right, take a break. So we're going back into that V-sit hold in 5 seconds. All right, let's go. up and hold for that full 20 seconds. Yeah, come on, hold tight, hold tight. Seconds, keep holding. All right, take a break. So last time through, start with that split squat hold, right leg forward. Let's go. There you go, hold tight. You got it. Come on now. Take a break, rest, get ready for the other side. About 5 seconds. And go. So make sure you don't let that front knee cave in. Push it out over the toes. Try to drive it towards your pinky toe. 3 seconds, almost there. Rest. Good job. So we're getting ready for that reverse plank. You can go ahead and drop down. It's our last time through on this. And go. Hips high. There you go. Come on, we got it. Keep holding. I know these are tough. Almost there. All right, rest. So last one, we got that V-sit hold. Challenge yourself on this. See if you can hit that straight leg position. All right, let's go. There we go. Find that balance and hold. You got 5 seconds. We're going to go into a stretch right after this. All right, we're going to go right into a pigeon stretch. So if you want to grab your water, you can. Drink some water real quick. And then we'll go right leg through and forward. And we'll go into that pigeon stretch. We got 2 stretches we're going to go through. And that'd be it. All right, so we're going to go a full 30 seconds on this. So we get everybody holding. Just relax. Stretch it out. Try to work that foot forward away from you a little bit. About 10 seconds longer. All right, let's switch legs. Later, Rosemary. Good work. Keep going, guys. Just hold. All right, we're going to go ahead and pick your weight up. We're going to a deep squat hold. So just get something light to hold out in front of you to help you balance so you can drop all the way down. We're going to hold this for 1 minute. So we're going to start here at that 1 minute, 30 second point on the clock. So you got about 10 seconds. We'll go 1 minute hold. Whatever you got, it can be light, it can be a water bottle, just something to help you kind of balance. All right, let's go. Try to sink down and hold that weight out in front. Hold. There you go. Shift your weight side to side a little bit. Try to work that chest upwards. Don't fall backwards. You got about 30 seconds. So if you're holding this with a real wide stance, I'm gonna challenge you, bring your feet in and then use your elbows to drive your knees outward. Like not super narrow, but like at least hip width. Get that adductor or inner thigh stretch. I know your legs are tired. It's the last thing we got today. 10 seconds left. And done. Good job, everybody. Let's see. Let me get stop recording here.